So, as Carl mentioned, we talked earlier, it's been a little funky year. I know that actually a couple weeks ago, that dreaded Thursday morning on the wall, lots of anxiety. Everybody wants to know what's going on. You know, the sales team are calling me and saying, what did we say? People want to know what the problem is. And, you know, I have to tell you, whenever you start thinking about what's the problem, I think that sometimes people jump to conclusions. You know, there's something always that they fixate on, the first thing that comes to their mind. And, you know, I'm the exact same way. You know, whenever there's a problem, people come to me and they say, what's the cause of the problem? Always first thing pops into my head is IJF. And every time, IJF, it's Jeff's fault. So, but anyway, the reality is that when there's a problem, there's usually not just one thing, there's a lot of things, and it's complicated. And, you know, we know that Carl mentioned the election year, a lot of just noise in the air. There was earlier in the year, you know, Facebook made some changes, and earlier in the year that I think changed things, lots of noise. But you know, we're trying to figure out what is the problem. I know a lot of you guys, when Jeff and I got on that Facebook Live, you may have seen it, I had a little booklet of all of these things, and you know, everybody wants to know what's in the package, you know, share with us what's in the package of all of the data that we looked at. And I'll tell you, we did look at a lot of data, and well, there's a lot of abstract stuff. We were able to sort of come up with one thing that seems fairly certain, and that's that it's not Jeff's fault. Beyond that, though, you know, the question still is there. So what is the problem? Why does volume seem lower now than it did before? Why, when I have, you know, the same number of active coaches in my organization that I did a year ago, why is volume lower? Well, we did do a lot of research, and I guess what I can say to answer that is, I don't know. But no, I don't know exactly. You know, the reality is, like I said, there's a lot of reasons. There is that noise out there, the election noise, there's no doubt. You know, when you look at your Facebook feed, there's a lot of stuff up there that is out of your control in terms of what people are seeing, and that has an impact. Now, there's no doubt that back in March when, you know, Facebook made whatever changes they made, it changed the environment a little bit. But the number, the data that we looked at, I'm sure a little bit, there were some things that came up in that too that impacts our thinking and want to share that with you. But really when it comes down to, I guess one answer, this isn't an answer why the change, but it is an answer of why you're feeling the volume issue. And it has to do really with Shakeology starts and activity that happened earlier in the year. So if you look at this chart, if you can see it, the bold line is 2016, the non-bold line is 2015, and you can see that we had a great start of the year. And so January, February, and March were up over above 2015 numbers, and then it started to fall. And you can see that in May, we actually dropped below the 2015 numbers in terms of starts. And you know, these starts primarily come, not exclusively, but primarily come through challenge pack sales. But we saw that, and you're saying, well, that was way back then. Everything was good. Why now am I feeling it? And the reason is that because of the compound effect, because when people buy Shakeology, when we get our customers on Shakeology, on average, they're about four turns. They stay in about 4 months on Shakeology. And so there was that sort of cushion of that carried us through. And you can see this other chart is around continuity billings. So these are just the billings of all of our continuity, the people, the HD orders. And you can see that while the line crossed back in May, because of the size of the file and those four turns, it wasn't really until until August of this year that then it started to cross, and then in September we felt it a little more, in October we felt it a little more. So the reality is that what you're feeling, it's not that the system isn't calculating orders. It's not, you know, that because we've discontinued some products, I can tell you there really aren't any lost orders. In terms of the discontinued products, they're very small volume that have been more than made up for the growth of the performance as we introduce that. But what it is the fact that we're selling less challenge packs. And we've been selling less challenge packs for most of this year. And so why are we selling less challenge packs? And at the same time, you guys are working hard. We know that you're working hard. We know that you're still bringing in lots of coaches. And so why are we, we're bringing in lots of coaches. Again, I have the same or more active coaches than I had before. What's different? Well, one thing that the data tells us is that the coaches we're bringing in now are a little less productive. Here's a little chart to look at. And this chart tells us, we basically broke the coaches into four segments. We have what we call at the bottom, our org builders. And so these are our most productive coaches. These are the coaches that are both retailing product and they're bringing in new coaches. We're calling these organizational builders because that's what they're doing. They're building their organization. We also have a group of coaches that join and they haven't really started building their organizations yet, but they are retailing product. And then we have another group, which we call our discount coaches, who really join coaching to get a 25% discount on Shakeology, and that's what they do. So we can count on these coaches to have, you know, their 90-point order every month, but not a lot of more productivity than that. And then we have our predominantly inactive coaches. Coaches join, they're not really buying or selling anything. But the bottom two rungs are the ones that are important. The bottom two on the stack chart. If you look back in 2014, our coach mix, our mix of coaches, 38% of them were in this sort of highly productive mode. When we go to 2015, 37% of them. Through the first half of this year, that number's down to 31%. So we're getting the coaches in, but overall the trend of the coaches is that they are less active than they have been in past years. So then the question is, why are they less active, right? Could it be that the selling environment is harder because of, you know, the election, Facebook changes things? Probably that's a contributor. Another contributor that we think we've unearthed in the data is that the thing that we're seeing is an increase in what we call direct-to-coach enrollments. So a direct-to-coach enrollment means that the person's first introduction to Team Beachbody is as a coach, as opposed to a customer-converted coach, somebody that started as a customer and then became a coach. And you can see on this line back, and this trend started actually back in 2014, really, that we started to see more of these, as a percentage, is direct-to-coach enrollment. So again, started back there at the bottom at about 53%, it's up closer to like 59% now. And you know, it's a little bit of an occurrence that happens in our companies as we grow, as we have more and more people earning a little bit of money, that like suddenly where we used to have this fitness story, suddenly now there's kind of this income opportunity story, that there can be a little bit of shift in behavior, a little bit easier to kind of in tough times market the business opportunity. And again, not saying that everybody's doing this, I'm not saying anything wrong, just this is what the data says. But as we look at these sort of direct-to-coach enrollments and we look at the performance of these direct-to-coach enrollments, the other thing that we're seeing is that these direct-to-coach guys are coming in and leaving faster. So you could see that in the same year, 26% of coaches who come in direct-to-coaching are leaving in that same year versus 17% of customers who have become coaches. Another interesting stat is that those customers that became coaches are actually earning 14% more in their first year than the coaches that are coming in direct. And so you say, why is this phenomenon? Why is there the difference between these two people? Well, I think that it has something to do with belief system. And you know, this is, I think it was in some of our training. Many years ago, I stole this chart out of a consultant that came to our office, and they were, they'd done a study on sort of the direct selling industry and had sort of looked at who were the very successful direct sellers and how, what was their milestone. And I adapted it a little bit for us, but basically those that were most successful went through a process in their life cycle. They were first introduced to the company, to the products, and almost the next step, which seems so obvious, but actually is such a difficult hurdle, is that they were introduced and then they actually engaged with the products. And it's something that seems like a no-brainer, that somebody's gonna buy our products and then they're gonna do them. But unless they do that, they're not starting that process of the belief system. And that's why our challenge is so critical. That's why getting people into the My Challenge Tracker and that engagement and community and working with products. Because when they actually engage and when they start to use it, what happens is out of that class, we start to get them enthusiasts. We start getting people excited about what they're doing. It's different than what they've done before, and it takes a little bit of time until they get excited about it. And then something magical happens. They start to become an organic advocate of the product and the system and the environment. And they start talking to their friends about it, and they start recommending their friends to talk to you. And suddenly, those are the people that are really ready to be a coach. Those are the people that, you know, it doesn't take a whole lot of training to tell them what to talk about, because they're already talking about it. And you know, and it's also for these people, it's a very different experience, I think, of sort of, when you sign up, when you buy a product and you're looking at physical results, as that person who's buying it, they have in their head sort of a line of success, of goals that they want to accomplish, and it's pretty clear what that goal is and what they're working towards. If at the same time you introduce that, you introduce the coaching opportunity, that adds another layer of goals and expectations to that brand new person. So what was originally a fairly simple thing that they were driving towards, now it's multi-layered, and there's a lot more goals and a lot more things that they're driving towards and have to think about. And you know what? Their probability of success in hitting those things probably lower. So it's probably why we're seeing, you know, the percentages of those direct coaches exiting the business faster than those customer converted coaches. Because the reality is that they're sort of cheated at times of experiencing the belief system, of having that opportunity to develop that belief system. And, you know, we're not telling people, stop recruiting coaches. What we're saying is, don't have expectations of those coaches until they've developed that belief system. And really, there's such an opportunity of focusing on those customers and having their results. And, you know, if you bring in a coach as a direct coach, nobody's chastising you, nobody's telling you you're doing anything wrong. But if you cheat them out of that process of building the belief system, it's likely they're not going to be successful. So, you know, we had a lot of discussion around this. Carl and I went up to Utah, we're talking with the sales team, and Jeff and Carl and I were sitting around, and it seems so obvious and that we shouldn't have to kind of put a name around it, but we are. And we're calling this the vital process. You heard Carl talking about this. Seems simple, and it seems like we're probably, many of us are doing this. But some of us aren't, and we want to remember that this is at the core of who we are and what we do, and that's this vital process, that we want to get customers started and get them started right. You know, we actually changed this instead of customers, we said clients, because there will be times when somebody, you know, you're going to sign somebody up directly as a coach, but don't cheat them out of this process. And the first step, once you get them in, once you sell them that challenge pack, your job is not over. And we need to make sure that the people on your teams know that their job is not over. It's more than a success club point. It's so much more important than getting that success club point. And you gotta get them started, and then that second part of the process, probably the hardest, it's more difficult than actually selling the product, is making sure that they get those results. Making sure they're engaged. Making sure that they fall in love the same way you have with the Beachbody products and the Beachbody community, and they become advocates. And when they're advocates, when they are organic advocates, actually advocating what we do, perfect time to make them a coach, to transition them into coaching, to onboard them correctly, to make sure they go through the first 30, make sure they're connecting with you, make sure they have their goals in line, make sure they know what to do, take them through, you know, your coach basics program, whatever that looks like. That transition process is an investment that we have to make. And then once they do that, get their footing under them, you have to keep developing and mentoring them and find out for you, what does that endpoint look like? What does that endpoint on the journey? For me, I would recommend that you stick with those guys until they're a team leader on the leadership ladder. Not just say, we gotta get you to diamond, right? Not just say, who can we recruit to get you, you know, a 12-person organization so that we can call you a diamond. That's great, it's awesome to be a diamond, but that really, they don't have stable footing under them yet. Think beyond that, think to the team leader position, because we know that that's where there's stability in the organization. But investing, we have to invest in all four phases of this process. And the reality as coaches is that we have to do it all simultaneously with different people because they're all at different states of the process. So we gotta figure out how do we do all of that. And that's what's so great about today and tomorrow's session is that we're gonna have coaches up here to talk to you about how they do, how they think about this process. And so hopefully you'll get some epiphanies out of that and you'll take it back. The next slide, I just had to put this slide in here. I know it was in Carl's deck, but it was actually in my deck first, and then Carl took it. He's the boss, so he got to do that. But anyway, so I took it out of my deck, and then I thought, I want to show that pretty little arc up. So I brought it back in. And I think that, you know, it's funny when you look at data. That's so funny, like, you think it's gonna be the answer, and it's just data. We were actually, that big deck that I had, it basically had all of this information, maybe a few more charts. I actually took the CAB through the whole deck, and we actually had to resuscitate Julie Boris. She passed out halfway through. She was overwhelmed with data, which I can get that way too. But the reality is that it's funny, like, you look at this chart, Carl mentioned it. So this is, what is that, that's 8 years of data, 8 data points on this. It's a data point for each year, and it's beautifully smooth and upward. But the reality is that things aren't really that smooth. And if we look back, there were these little, you know, trials and tribulations. Even just this past year, we had the warehouse, you know, we transitioned to the warehouse and couldn't get orders out. Oh my God. We started earlier this year on the corporate side, we had fraud and, you know, like fraud issues. We had to change our operations, and that was causing order delays. And you guys in Pittsburgh and Facebook. And by the way, this little curvy line, those aren't the actual data points. We just drew a little line on there. So if you try to calculate where were they in August of 14th, like, you're going to be wrong. But the reality is that that's our business, and we're in right now one of these little challenging points. And I think, you know, as we go forward, our line's probably gonna look something like this. We're gonna get through this little challenging point. Sometimes, you know, Jeff was so great when we were in Utah and we were talking about some of these issues, and we were talking about, you know, this shift. There's definitely a shift of people direct coach recruiting. So we would sometimes see it on Facebook, we'd see it in places. And Jeff kind of said, so best, he said, you know, like, we haven't swung the pendulum like the other way. We just somehow got like one click off in the alignment. And I think that's where we are. We're one click off in the alignment. And I think that when we click back, we're gonna get there, and we're gonna, and you know, I know that what's so exciting with our leadership and the development of our leadership is that I know you can get frustrated, but I know that you're tenacious, and I know that you're dedicated, and I know that you have the belief in our mission and in our products, and I know that we're gonna find our way out of this. If Facebook changed, we're gonna find the new path. If you know, whatever it is, we need to examine everything and keep going forward. And that's the beauty of, you know, having the team that we have of coaches out here. So here's what I'm gonna leave with. I guarantee you, we're gonna have these little up and down things over the course of our existence as Team Beachbody. But I also feel 100% confident that just like Elizabeth Harkey's line at the bottom of her little thing, our line is just going to tilt up because of who we are.